Mr. Van Dong here with week 7, day 2 math distance learning. Today we are in chapter 12, lesson 11, and we are going to be finding the volume of composite figures. So yesterday we built the composite figures and we could see each individual little cube. And today we're not going to be able to see the cubes. We're going to have measurements for the outside, and we're going to use our algorithms and addition and spatial reasoning to be able to solve these problems. Remember that volume is found in one of two ways. You can find volume by multiplying length, width, and height, or you can find volume if they give you a surface area or a base of an object. You can find it with a base times the height, and base is usually the length times the width of the bottom layer. Now, most of the problems today, you're going to be focused on this up here, okay? But I don't want us to forget that sometimes a problem will combine length and width with the information that they give you, and then you need to multiply that base by the height. So keep that in mind. I'll turn that sound off real quick over here. I'm going to be distracted by little beeps from my computer. Right, so page 967. And the first thing that we've got here is the Arc de Triomphe. I don't speak French. I'm sorry. If you have people in your life that can say things correctly in French, that's great. I can't do it. So I'm going to quickly copy down this object. Right here, there we go. Okay, so they give us some measurements of this object. This we can think of as three separate rectangular prisms here. So we've got the measurements across here. This is 50 yards. They wouldn't measure it in yards in France. They're using meters. Come on, math book. And then it's got two sections here. It notes that there's a 22-yard section here and a 32-yard section here. There's a 24-yard here, 17-yard here, and 17-yard here. Now, I kind of wish they would have started with something that was just two rectangular prisms put together. This one is three. It's going to work out, but it's like, it's slightly more complex. It's not a lot more complex, but ultimately what we want to do here, first of all, there's a bunch of lines up here that aren't labeled. And so that can be a point of confusion. For example, how far across is it right here at the front top? It's also 50 yards. I hope you're screaming. So it's not labeled as 50 yards, but we can know based on our spatial reasoning that if the backside is 50, if this is a rectangular prism, if that backside's 50, then this edge is also gonna be 50. For example, it doesn't give us the total height, which we won't need, so it's okay. It doesn't give us the total height, but we could find it by adding the 22 and the 32. It doesn't say how tall this is. How tall is it? It's 32, that's why they give us it in these two bits here. So basically, what they've done here is they're giving us as if this has been cut like so, so that there are two rectangular prisms on the bottom and one on the top, just like stacking blocks as a kid and, you know, building those things up. And it shows you that picture beneath. It shows you those separated out right here. And it says, you know, so what's the volume of each of the, I'm going to call them legs. What's the volume of the legs? And then what's the volume of the top piece, and then put them all together, and that'll give you the total volume. So it's easy to lose track of which numbers you actually need when you're finding composite volume. So I've separated this into two legs and a top piece, and I'm going to be very specific about drawing. Hey, for this one, my formula is length times width times height. So the length. How far deep is it? How far this way? It's not labeled, right? So I need to find somewhere else on the object that's the same. And that's this part right here. It's 20. If it's 24 long here, then it's also 24 right there. So I'm going to write, it's going to be 24 times. What's the width? The width is labeled here. It's 17. What's the height? It's not labeled over here. It's labeled over here, right? 32 times 32. And I'm not going to solve that yet. I'm going to find what the formulas are for the other ones too. Now this, it's the same, right? It's also a 17 by 24 by 32. So I'll just go ahead and make a note that that's also right there. And if I want to, once I find the total volume of one leg, I could multiply it by two to find the volume of both legs, or I could add them together, right? Because there's two groups of them. And then up here at the top one, we've got what's the length? The length is also that same 24. What is the width all the way across? All the way across is 50. And then what is the height here is 22. 22. You're welcome. Okay, none of these numbers play nicely together, so I am going to stack and multiply. And I feel like doing 24 times 17 first, because I'm just gonna go left to right. So I'm gonna bust out a section where I'm showing my work. There's a lot of multiplication in these problems. If you need a separate sheet of paper, get out a separate sheet of paper to jot these down, if you have a whiteboard or something, but we're practicing our multiplication fluency for sure. So 24 times 17, I'm gonna do 7 times 24, and I'm gonna do 10 times 24, and then I'm gonna add them together. 7 times 4 being 28, 7 times 2, it's two tens, but I can think about 7 times 2 is 14, plus 2 is 16, I use that, so I'm gonna cross it out. I'm now working in the tens place, so I'm gonna annex a 0 right there, so I can think about this being as being 1 times 4, even though it's actually 10 times 4, and then 1 times 2, even though it's actually 10 times 20, that's why it ends up in 200s. It's two in the hundreds place. Anyway, so there we go. I've done that, and I've got 408. I'm done, right? No, not even close. So now I know that this is 408, and I still need to multiply by 32. Now, some kids right now would then put times 32 right here and keep going, and you actually technically shouldn't do that. This is one whole problem that has been solved. We're done with it. Now we're solving a different problem, so you should start the work all over again. You might as well practice that for when it matters in things like algebra and geometry when you're doing proofs. So I'm gonna do 2 times 408, and I'm gonna do 30 times 408. 2 times 8 being 16, 2 times nothing is 0, plus 1 is 1. I've used that, 2 times 4 being 8. So 816, which makes sense because 400 doubled is 800 and 8 doubled is 16. So we've got 816. I'm gonna annex a 0 because I'm working in the tens place, and I'm gonna think about 3 times 8 being 24, and 3 times nothing being nothing plus 2 is 2, and 3 times 4 being 12. So, and that makes sense too. If I think about 3 times 400, then it's gonna, or 30 times 400, then that would make it 12,000, and 30 times 8 would be 240. So that's, you know, put together there. So I add those bad mamma jammas up, and I get 13,056. And that is for one leg. Okay, so this leg right here is 13,056. Maybe once I solve it, I'll write it inside of it so I don't forget. This is 13,056 cubic yards, and so is this, 13,056 cubic yards. There we go. All right, not done. Okay, I gotta do the top. 24 times 50 times 22. I'm gonna do 24 times 22 first because I'm hoping that I can multiply whatever it is by 5 in my head and then make it 10 times bigger. So I'm gonna do 24 times 22. 2 times 24 is 48. I could do 2 times 4 is 8, 2 times 2 is 10. And then this will be 10 times, this is gonna be 2 times 24, but 10 times bigger. So it's gonna be 480. So I can think about annex a 0 and then, you know, multiply them up and get that. And then we add them up for 528. I'm drawing the arrows to the ones that I multiplied together. And I still have to do times 50. 528 times 5 in my head is going to be 5,000, half of 5,280, which is 2,500 plus 140. Too much to keep track of, right? I might be able to do it if I really concentrate, but I'm just going to stack and multiply to make sure that I don't make a mistake. So I've got 528. Times 50. All of this is going to be zeros, and then I'm going to have a 0 for the tens place. 5 times 8 is 40. 5 times 2 is 10, plus 4 is 14. 5 times 5 is 25, and 1 is 26. For 26,400 cubic yards. Okay, I got to add all those up to get my final answer. I'm just going to stack them all because I might be able to do 56 plus 56, and I can do the 13,000 plus 13,000 in my head. I'm less confident about 56 plus 56 in my head if I'm a fifth grader. So I'm going to stack them all up, 26,400. I'm carefully going to stack them up by place value. Another 1356. Put them together, and what do you get? Well, that one's a 12, and then there's an 11, there's a 5, and then there's a 12, and then there's a 1, 2, 5. 52,512 cubic yards. That's composite figures. So you can see all of the we've been saying all year long, multiplication is our bread and butter in fifth grade. It's what we've got to be able to do. We have to be able to do multiplication problem after multiplication problem, bing, bang, boom, decimals or otherwise. And you can see why now. This is sort of the culmination of that multiplication of elementary school, is finding the composite figures here. Now, some of you are thinking, Mr. Van Dong, there was an easier way. And I don't think they talk about this in the, let me turn the page and make sure that I'm not crazy. Yeah, I'm not crazy. Some of you right now are saying, Mr. Van Dong, you did more work than you needed to. If you would have multiplied 50 times 54 times 24, you could have found the volume of the whole thing if it were filled in. And then you could have found the volume of the missing part and subtracted it out. And then there actually only would have been two volume problems and a subtraction problem. And that's true. I could have done it that way. I didn't, because we're kind of focused right now on adding things together. But it's also true that you can find volume with subtraction by thinking about what the whole cube would be and then taking a part away. Usually we think about adding them up though. Okay. Whew, 12 minutes, one example. Go ahead and turn the page. We're going to do example two now, and then I'll release you to work on these other ones. Again, this is it's one of the more important things that we do in fifth grade, because it's just all of the multiplication we've been working on all put together. So hopefully, we're feeling pretty fluent in it. Example two says, find the volume of the composite figure. And it is drawn for us there. Let me quickly copy it down. Okay, it's something like this. And it's pretty long. And there we go, something like that. Okay, this one does give us a base. Good thing we wrote this down. All right, so it says that this right here is 0.2 or 2/10 of a meter. It says that the length here is 2 meters, and our height here, the whole thing, is 2.2 meters. Notice that this section right here would not be 2.2 meters. It's this outside section, right? That's longer than this section right here. It would be a little bit shorter. Watch out for that. It says that there's a base right here of 4 square meters. And again, here we have 0.2 meters. And then right here, it says that's 2 meters right here. So the section, so now we have to decide how to chop this up. And because they're saying that this section here is 4 meters, I think we kind of have to cut it like this in this particular situation. So we're thinking of that cut being made right there to make two composite figures, this like tall vertical piece and the shorter piece right here. So we've got, how are we going to find the volume of this? Well, we've got the base of 4 square meters, and we're going to multiply that by 2/10 of a meter, because that's its height. How are we going to find the volume here? Excuse me. Well, we've got the length is what? 2 meters. Oops, I don't need to write meters right now for this part. And what's the width? 2/10 of a meter. And what is the height? 2 2/10 of a meter. So let's get to it. So side note, did we need to know that that was 2 meters? No. You don't. So here's a common mistake. A common mistake when we're doing volume, kids will go, it's a lot of numbers, I'm going to multiply them all together. No, don't do that. You need to actually think about breaking them into separate rectangular prisms, how to find the volume of each one, and do it that way. So sometimes there's extra information. We actually don't need to know that that section is 2 meters there. All right, so let's multiply. I'm gonna do this one in my head. I know that 4 times 2 is 8, but because in the factors, there's a number that is 1/10 the size of my known fact, then my product will also be 1/10 the size. So it's 8/10 of a cubic meter. Okay, so this section right here is 8/10 of a cubic meter. Okay, and then over here, let's see, I want to multiply this together first because I know that 2 times 2 is 4, but again, because one of my factors is 1/10 the size of my known fact, then this is also going to be 1/10 the size of my known fact for 4/10, and I still have 2 and 2/10. I can multiply 4 times 22 in my head by using the double-double strategy. Whenever you multiply by 4, you're double-doubling. Remember, I'm saying 4 times 22 right now because I'm ignoring the decimal. I'm going to adjust for the decimal after my known fact. 4 times 22 will be 22 double-doubled. 22 doubled is 44. 44 doubled is 88. So here we've got 88, but the factors are 1/10, and then again, 1/100 the size, a total of 1/100 the size. So our decimal in our known fact of 88 shifts to the left twice for 88 hundredths of a cubic meter. So right here we've got 88 hundredths of a cubic meter. And then we've got to add those together. So again, opportunity for error if we weren't careful with decimal addition. You guys really nailed decimal addition. It's been several months. Remember, we need to stack these. We're going to add these together, stack them by the decimal. So I've got 88 and again, 8 like this. There's an invisible zero here. I stack them by the decimal. So that's 8/100 plus nothing is still 8/100. 8/10 and 8/10 is 16/10, which is 1 and 6/10 for a final answer of that composite figure being 1 and 68/100 of a cubic meter. Okay, you're going to solve the guided practice problems. This one, they've already chopped it up for you. In fact, in all of these, they've already chopped it up for you. You can see that they've really separated them out in a kind way. So find the volume of each individual rectangular prism and then add them together. And then I do want to warn you that when we get to the test on Friday, it won't, my math makes it a little bit easier than really the standard is in fifth grade. They already show you what cuts to make. And just like up here, I didn't, be prepared to have to figure out, okay, do I want to cut it this way or this way? And you could do either as long as you're able to figure out what those measurements are. You should always be able to do it either way, but then you need to be very careful with your spatial reasoning. All right. Finish the assignment as usual. Work for 45 minutes minus the length of this video, or until you're done. And I'll talk to you later.